Today we are going to design a website using our Cisco Packet Tracer. This is laboratory experiment number 5. Okay, in the OSI layer, we working with the application layer essential. Application layer provides the means for end-to-end connectivity between individuals in the network using data networks. As we know, the goal of network system is to provide the communication in the fastest and shortest path possible. Server is an important tool in this experiment. It responds from the entire client's response or request because servers contain files and information and manages it depending on the application. One of the server's roles is to manage its web. And in HTML programming, we can design various websites and links, change its fonts and contents, and provide information and images and make it available at the World Wide Web. In this experiment, we will simulate programming, but we will use Cisco Packet Tracer to visualize what happens in a network system when it comes to web design. So at the end of this activity, we are expected to have been able to design a Cisco based web programming system, determine the difference between static and dynamic routing, creating our own websites and links, determine the function of the server in networks, identify how the server responds at the client's request. So here are the procedures. Okay, so we are starting now. We open the Cisco Packet Tracer. Then we're going to our network components here. We are going to use 3 PCs, 2 switches, and for now we are going to use 2 servers. So, 1. PC 0, PC 1, and then PC 2. Then we're going to get 2 switches. We're going to use a generic switch here and here. Okay. 2 servers. Go to end devices, generic server, server here, there, okay. So before we connect the devices together, we are going to change the label on PC0 to dynamic. Oh, it's PC 0 PC 1 to dynamic. PC2 to static. Okay. In PC2, since its name is static, we are going to configure its IP address. So we are going to use 172.16.0.90. Want to config. I'm going to go to static and fast Ethernet IP configuration. Okay, 172.16.0.90. Then going to use subnet mask of 255.255.0.0. Okay. Okay, just make sure that the packet tracer is on real-time mode. Then we are going to configure our DHCP server. So let's pick server 0 and rename it to DHCP server. Okay. We then go to double click it and we go to config. We go to its global settings. We are going to set its gateway to 172.16, which is also going this would be the gateway of this DHCP server. Oh wait. 172.16.0.1. Okay, I'm going to configure its fast Ethernet. I'm going to be .16.0.10 and the subnet mask 255.255.0.0. Okay, then we go to services. We are going to set the HTTP service and HTTPS service off. Turn it off. Then we're going to set the DHCP default gateway with DHCP. We turn this on and then we're going to change the default gateway to 172.16.0.10. Oh, that one. And then we're going to configure the DNS server to 172.16.0.11. Then we're going to set the start IP address to 172.16.0.100. Okay, this determines the range of the IP address that will be used, and then we click on add or save, since the pool name would be the server pool. Save. Okay, and then we are going to go to set the DNS service, set it off, make sure that also the emails SMTP and PO3 service are off. Okay. We set this aside for now. We're now going to configure our DNS server. Again, we are going to go to config. We set its global settings. The default gateway would be 172.16.0.1. We go to fast Ethernet. We set its IP address. It's 172.16.0.11. Go to 255.255.255. I mean, it's 255.255.0.0. Then go to services. Go to take HTTP. We make sure that it's off. We go to DHCP service. Turn it off. Then we're going to DNS. Going to turn it on. And then we are going to add a domain name. Going to set hamaes.edu to a specific IP address 172.16.0.20. We click on add. And then we're going to add another one, www.internal.com, with an IP address of 172.16.0.30. I click on add. Okay. We check if the email service is off. Okay, this would be our DNS server. Now we are also going to add a web server. Web server. Double click it again. And we name it, we are going to name this www.amaes.edu. This would be the web server. We go to config, we set the default gateway to 172.16.0.1. And then we are going to fast Ethernet. Going to configure. If you remember, we did that on DNS. We're going to set this web server to an IP address of 172.16.0.20 with a subnet mask of 255.255.0.0. Now on services, we are going to set the HTTP and HTTPS servers on, and then we go to index.html. This would be the splash page. We go to edit, then change this the title, change this to AMA Computer University, or AMA Online Education System. Then Just edit this. Okay, we click on save. We just leave this behind for now. We could also edit this, the links, hello world.html, copyrights. We could edit this later. Save. Okay, let's see if our small network topology is working. So we go to our connections, go to automatic connection here. We connect switch. Connect all the service to switch one. Okay. Okay. Maybe it's full. I'm just going to here. Let's connect it here. Okay. Going to wait if all of the nodes are green. We could fast forward time. Okay, all the nodes are green. We're going to check if we could access our AMA education system web page using PC, the dynamic PC here, PC0. We go to desktop, we go to browser, and we input the web page. Okay, you can see that the host name, it says that the host name is unresolved, so we should tinker this a bit. Let's see. Go to config. Going to see if it's here's the problem. We go to DHCP. We go to DHCP here. DHCP to global. Go to DHCP here. Go to DHCP. Okay. So what's happening now is this, the dynamic PCs. These are given IP addresses from the server from our DHCP server. So it automatically gives out IP address on these two end devices. So let's see if we could connect to the website now. Go to the web browser. www.amaes.edu. Yeah, there. It's now working. We're going to check if our static PC with a static IP address is working. We set the gateway here to 72.16.0.1, and then the DNS server would be 172.16.0.1. 0.11, if we remember the DNS server is that. We go and check if it's working. Go to web browser. I'm going to guess that already. Okay. We could connect to our small AMA website here. So there is a proposed activity in our laboratory experiment. So we are now going to create a web server to internal.com, and then we'll just follow the instruction like what we do on we did on our AMA education system web server, and then we create a website regarding our artificial intelligence. So we go again to our network components and then end devices, and then we select a server, another server. We name this as web server www.internal.com. Now we configure the web server. Again, the gateway would be 172.16.0.1. Yeah, 172.16.8.0.11. Yes, go to our static. If you would remember, our on our DNS server, we configured the internal www.internal.com. We set an IP address of 172.16.0.30. So we set this as .30. 172.16.0.30. Okay. Try and connect it now. See if this switch works. Okay, I guess it's lacking another port. So we go here. Switch here. Why is it not connecting? Double check the ports are on. There's one internet port here. So maybe we would need another switch. Set another switch. This one. And then we connect it here. To this PC. How many ports are there? Okay. We are going to get another switch for it to work. Okay, so that we could make this tidier. Going to change our switch. Need more ports. Could never have more ports. Here, two switches here. Okay, connect them all there. Okay, so we fast forward time. I'm going to check the services here. Again, we are going to click edit on our index.html. This would be the splash page. Okay, change this to artificial. Actually, we could elaborate on our web page design, but since we are using our Cisco Packet Tracer, there are limitations to this program. So let's make this simple. Artificial intelligence. We could give a definition of our artificial intelligence. Okay. Search artificial intelligence. Okay, we could give this. So that we could give a good size to the website. Forgive me for copying and pasting, I don't know much about artificial intelligence, but this will do the trick. Okay. So go to our web page again and then set artificial intelligence. Okay, that would be enough. Maybe change this to say more info. Could go to the hello world.html. Go to HTTP hello world. Change what it's saying here and give it some information. Here, go to the website. Here. Okay, I guess we're done. Let's check if it's working. So we go to a PC. So you just go to desktop and then we go to check in the web browser www.internal.com. Okay, it's working. So if you click on information, this is a simple website, by the way. Yeah, it's working. So there, we just learned how to create a web server DHCP website. We learned the DHCP server, which gives out automatic IP address to a set number of website. If you remember, we set the start IP address to 172.16.0.100. So from 0 to 100, those are the IP address that this server could give out to end devices. And then we created a web server for AMA education system, and we created another web server for our artificial intelligence website. So we just finished our experiment, and then we are on to our questions. Okay, on to questions. What are HTTP, DNS, and DHCP? HTTP is a request response standard between a client and the server. A client is the end user, the server is the website. The client making an HTTP request using a web browser, spider, or other end user tool is referred to as the user agent. The responding server, which stores or creates resources such as HTML files and images, is called the origin server. The DHCP, or Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol, automates the assignment of IP address, subnet mask, default gateway, and other IP parameters, and the DNS, or domain name system, associates various sorts of information with domain names. Most importantly, it serves as the phone book for the internet by translating human readable computer host names. So what is the difference between the web design and using HTML compared to a Cisco Packet Tracer? It is like making a website using the old-fashioned way, using notepad, like in the 90s. Unfortunately, I'm one of those people that learned the hard way. There are limitations, of course, depending on the skill of the programmer. The Cisco Packet Tracer is designed to simulate. Question 3. What can you conclude from this activity? That it is convenient to use a DHCP server, especially on a large-scale enterprise, because imagine if you are going to manually input IP addresses to multiple devices, from smartwatches to laptops to refrigerators or anything that has that could access the internet. It is easier to assign IP addresses this way. Also, DNS servers make surfing the web easier by using a human readable computer host names, meaning that we're just going to input on www. The name of the website instead of typing IP addresses on the address bar. So this concludes our experiment number 5. On to the next. Thank you.